ब्रह्मविद्याय वृत्यवे ब्रह्मविद्याचार्याय नचिकेतसे च।
लॉर्ड यमा हैज अनफोल्डेड द आत्मस्वरूप फ्रॉम डिफरेंट स्टैंडपॉइंट yet he is not satisfied. Why? From your face you could make out. From your face he could make out that you have not grasped. Don't think Atma Jnana is so easy. Even Lord Krishna admits it is difficult. Yamaraja admits it is difficult. Every master admits difficult. But nowadays, in the name of Vedanta, some management, some tricks to handle the mind, some psychotherapy, something you add and think that it is Vedanta. It is not. Difficulty in gaining the knowledge as per Vedanta is because of lack of preparedness of the mind. See, you burn the wood. When you light the fire, wood will catch the fire immediately, provided wood is dry. Suppose the wood is wet, what will happen?
Smoke.
Then we shed tears because of smoke. Is it not? Gunpowder will blast with a spark if it is dry. If it is not so, any number of matchboxes you exhaust, it is not so. So if that is the case, what is the dryness of our mind and what is the wetness of our mind? What is the... Who has to get the knowledge? Mind, buddhi, buddhi. Which mind is dry, buddhi is dry, which one is wet? You know it. A mind riddled with desire is wet. A mind with perfect vairagya is the most dry, like a dry wood. Therefore, what should be done first? You should first convince yourself about two things. What is that? Utility of your what you are pursuing. Number two, it is so, it cannot be otherwise. A modern man can ask you, what are you doing, sir? You have got, see, a pot full of water, you are throwing them and you are relying on the clouds. Are you intelligent one? You throw the water in the pot and expect the water from where? Like that, you are throwing out the enjoyment from the sense object and you are talking of something which is not, you are not seen at all, Atma, Brahma, etc. Are you wise enough? No, what do you answer? Answer no. That means you also feel correct. It is so. We have not seen Atma. Anybody has seen Atma? You know that there was an internet long back with Abdul Kalam as the president, a conversation between a professor and a new student was there. Actually, the professor is asking the student, is there God? Yes, sir. Have you seen him? No, sir. Have you heard about him? No, sir. Have you touched him? It went on and on and on and on and on, on and on. Finally, it turned to the student. Sir, professor, sir, have you got a brain? Any student, has any student seen the brain? Has any student touched the brain? That means professor doesn't have brain. And it went on. Then he said, oh, you rely on faith, etc. Yes. And that student was Abdul Kalam. That student, I put it in very interesting. I have no all points, etc., but very interesting dialogue. Turn back, turn, and he turns back. And that student was none other than Abdul Kalam. Now, science will ask you one thing, that science pathetically is unaware of, is the science of means of knowledge. What is the other word for this? What is it?
Epistemology.
Epistemology. Epistemology. See, this science very pathetically lacks epistemology. You take our Indian culture, even a Charvaka, Charvaka means the atheist materialism. He asserts, he may be wrong, but first he ascertains epistemology, jnana sadhana, means of knowledge, pramana, accordingly. He may be wrong. Every school of thought, first of all, every school of thought, first of all, ascertains the pramana. Pramana means jnana sadhana. In English, we can put it means of knowledge. If means of knowledge is wrong, the knowledge that you have got is wrong. Suppose you are seeing two moons. What are you seeing? Eyes. Are there two moons? So where is the defect? What is it? Cataractus. Get it rectified. So like that, don't rely on that. In fact, I moved there. I read an article by Nani Panki on the olden days. Get the point. He said, look, you are relying too much on the science. Look, what we see here with our eyes, forms which fit in the category of vibgya, the light that we are using. Vibgya is spectrum of seven colors. He says, suppose your eyes are geared to X-ray wavelength, without the damage to the eye, what will you see now? Come on, imagine. Your eyes are geared to X-ray wavelength without a damage to your eyes. What is that? Ascetically good. Opening the jaws and saying, and I am saying, open the skeleton sitting here. You hear the sound within the range of pitch of human audibility. Have you seen? Dogs, etc. They can hear the sound below the range of audibility of human ears. Olden days, the police used to have a whistle whose pitch was beyond the range of, very high pitch, beyond the range of human audibility. The thief is not able to hear the whistle. Now, do you mean to say what these dogs, cats hear is wrong and you will true? Suppose a vulture can see from a distance even the minutest thing. Can you? Do you say what the vulture has seen is not there? Is what is that? What you perceive through your eyes, ears, nose, tongue, touch is limited within that periphery. There is avenue of knowledge beyond, below. Which of these you are going to take as correct? Knowledge must have its correctness. Knowledge must have its validity. It cannot be negated. Then only knowledge. If any knowledge can be negated, it is not knowledge we call Brahma. Delusion. Appearance. See, the famous example of Rajju Sarpa. Vedanta gives Rajju Sarpa. A rope mistaken for a snake. Now snake is seen then. You can your eyes deny the snake? No. But do you take that snake as real? So that means appearance is not the criterion of reality. What is the criterion of reality? Abhaditva. So, what is the criterion of reality? Not appearance. Do you experience a dream or not? Is the experience criterion of reality? Will you accept the dream as real? You are Paramajnani on the waking up. What is it? Dream was wrong. You say dream is wrong. Dream is mithya. But do you deny your experience of dream? No. So that means experience or appearance by itself is not the criterion of reality. Criterion of reality is it should not be negated. You know? Think. Vedanta is not make-believe things. You have to discover yourself. It only guides you how to inquire. And this inquiry is based on Upanishads. Upanishads are from Vedas. Vedas are Isharokti. Why Ishara should bluff? And not only that, truth of this has been verified by great masters of the past. So therefore, so now, criterion of reality is what is called as non-availability for negation, which is not available for Badha. Badha means, now you understand, a rope appeared as snake, you brought the light, saw the rope, snake is Badhita. At least you don't understand that Badhita, because in your English that negation word is not that proper word. Badha, it should be Badhita. We can use Annaly, annulment of marriage. all this comes. But there are no worries. Bada is Bada. Maya is Maya. Accent, American, Maya. Accent, which is, what word is? Mithya is Mithya. But it is Mithya. Few words you can't translate in English. So, Badha, negation, let us accept the word negation. And then, what we are seeing, is it wise enough to throw the water in the pot in your hand and rely where? Clouds get to come. Like that. Like that you get from the sense of that. You deny that Atma is Paramananda. Brahma is Paramananda. What's it? What will you do? First, settle account with sense object. Are they real? Real. How do you say? Because you experience. Just now we have seen. Experience by itself need not be a criterion of reality. And what test we have to apply? What is the test of reality? Abhadita. Abhadita means which never see this to exist. Which is never absent. Snake was there, but it ceased to exist the moment you saw the rope in its place. Is it not? Like that. If Vishaya Bhoga, sense pleasure, were real, it should pass the test of what? Abhadhitattva. Agree? Afterwards you can't go back. If you have got any argument, you know itself. Fine. Yes. Now tell me, sense objects and sense pleasure, do they last ever? Every day you can prove. In sleep, are they there? In dream, your present things are there. You know once Janaka's dream? Janaka was in the royal court, dinner was over, entertainment was going on, dance was going on, queen was pressing the feet, etc. On the throne he dozed off. The queen saw it. He gave a sign, all dancers disappear, so that his sleep should not be disturbed. After some time, he started shouting, is this real or is that real? Is this real or is that real? So Queen asked, Maharaj, what are you asking? No, is this real? She sent for the ministers. Minister. Only he says, is this real or is that real? That nothing else. Finally, Vasishtha was some, Sage Vasishtha. So he asked, Maharaj, what happened? Same thing, gramophone yoga. Easily. Then Vasishtha, by his yogic power, went in the past and saw what has happened. Janaka had dreamt. He had lost his kingdom, he was exiled in the forest, and he could not get food to eat for a week together. At the end of the week, dream, he got one piece of dry roti, he got hold of that, he was about to eat, a dog came and snatched him, and he woke up. He is asking, is this real that I am emperor? With full stomach dozing off, or am I the one that one who was in exile for 1 week I could not? So now who is the Vasishtha? Maharaj, neither that is real nor neither that is real nor this is real. You take your waking, you as the emperor, that is real, that also is not real. You wake up to your Swarupa, this also what? Disappears as what? Dream. So like that. Let us not wait until we wake up to Swarupa. Sleep is enough. In sleep, enough. In dream you are present. Status and all, bank balance, nothing is there. Suppose, President of India, not India. President of America. India is better economy than American economy. American is a false economy. Economists have told me, Indian economy is a solid economy. Whereas American economy is a borrowed economy. So there are fools to give you a loan, therefore they are in whatever it may be. President of America gave you $1 billion check with camera on, etc. Proof. Morning. And you deposited where? Your bank account. And the morning you went to withdraw. Straight away you put what? Few crores. The banker is asking, can you give me? Hey, yesterday night I have put deposit $1 billion check. Can you argue? No. Suppose a gentleman dreamt that he had committed a murder in the dream. Very God-fearing man. So on waking up, he went to the police station. I have committed a murder. Where, when, all this? He said, we shall go to get lost. They both calm. Yeah, this stupid person. Will he take seriously? Come on. What is the criterion of reality? Abhajitattva. Present day that it is in your hand. A multi-billionaire industrialist who suppose he died. He may be afterwards born as a sepoy in the same office. Possible. You can't even specify. He was owning the such an industry. You must be there. No, I was the owner of this. Bhagati. He was the son and the grandchildren can drive him about, etc. Which is real. So therefore, what we have to rely upon is Pramana, the means of knowledge. What is our present day Pramana? What meets the eyes? Means Pratyaksha, direct perception. Indriyas, sense organs, are defective. They do report about the world which is useful to interact with the world. Vyavahara, yes. But it is not paramartha, it is not reality. What we are ascertaining is reality, having got which there is no loss after. Nobody can take it. Impossible to take it. And Vedanta says, it is your true nature. What is called Atma, Brahma, same principle. From the creation standpoint, is called Parameshwara, Bhagavan, Ishwaratattva. Now, this is difficult. Why difficult? Mind is not yet ready. Why mind and intellect not ready? It is wet. What is wet? Vairagya is lacking. Still the pulls of sense objects are there. So long as the pulls of sense objects are there, mind is preoccupied in the sense object. That mind, which is extrovert, cannot be introvert to discover the soul. Then now you understand why Nachiketa was tested by Yamaraja, if you remember. Ramaraja tried to entice him by offering everything. But Nachiketa stooped his guts. He says, Na vittena tarpani yo manusha palya study. Man can never be satiated by vitta means all that you can get, all pleasures that you can get. I want. So that's why. So having tested, he went on teaching, and he know it is difficult. And was last the conclusion of the last will you have seen? Mother Shruti, whose love is more than thousands of parents, is telling us, discover this truth, have Shraddha in them. Yamaraja, knowing fully well it is difficult, same thing is unfolded from a different standpoint with different analysis. But Krishna does same thing. See, generally, in literature, repetition is a defect. You say, Ardha Matra Laghavena Putrotsavam Manyante Pandita. By writing a composition, even a letter or a half letter is reduced, Pandita, scholars celebrate as the son is born. Son is born, happy newsletter. So, repetition or the same is a defect in literature. In teaching, one has to resort to repetition. I think Greek or Latin saying is that repetition is the mother of learning. Repetition is the mother of learning. It is necessary. So that's why same truth from different standpoint is present to them. If this method doesn't click, perhaps this method may click. If this doesn't click, perhaps that may click. So that is how it is. Because lokaha bhinna ruchaya. Taste of people differ. In fact, when we are learning in the ashram, after 6 months, many brahmacharya, what is the same thing? Same thing is not. In spite of teaching the same thing, if you not repeat it, what has happened? So therefore now we have got unfoldment of Atma Swarupa or true nature from a different analytical point.
Punaha api pravarantarena brahma tattva nirdharanarthaha अयम आरंभः दुर्विज्ञेयत्वात् ब्रह्मणः.
पुनः अपि अगेन अयम आरंभः इज द बिगिनिंग. अगेन मीन्स यमराज हैज ऑलरेडी रिपीटेड, इज ऑलरेडी टॉट फ्रॉम डिफरेंट स्टैंडपॉइंट. But he is not still contented. Again. Punahapi. Prakarantarena. In a different way. Topic is the same. Presentation is different. Destination is same. Route is different. Destination is same. Vehicle is different. So like, route is different. प्रकार ने ब्रह्म तत्व निर्धारणार्थः टू एसर्टेन द ब्रह्म तत्व द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ब्रह्म प्रिंसिपल ऑफ आत्मा द रियलिटी अंडरलाइंग एंटायर जगत. व्हाट इज ब्रह्म What is Brahma? Swamiji, have you known? We will not have come here. At least have you heard some words about Atma Brahma? Yes. You are an Indian. Whether you know Vedanta or not, whether you want to know Vedanta or not, few words, you cannot miss being in India, whether you like or not. Have you heard Sachidananda? Not the name of someone, okay? Sachidananda. At least you have heard Ananda. Chit word you have heard. Sat word you have heard. What is Sat? Is. Are you there? What is your answer? Give me a sentence. I am there. But I am there. I am there. You do it like that. Station master. During British period, see, very small stations means, you know, either station master, either booking clerk, either ticket waiter, either sweeper of the platform, you're different. So one train halted at a very remote village station. One Englishman was there, but Assam. So he got up. There are no passengers, much etc. One gentleman was there. Yeah. Who is the station master? I is the station master, sir. Sir, because of white skin. I just said, are you the station master? Yes, sir, I am the station master. Yes, sir, I am the station master. The butler is English. You know that butler English? You don't know? You should know. You must have heard this word, but you don't know why it is so. Butler English, they say. See, an Englishman had an Indian cook. One day what happened? A cat came and ate the butter. He doesn't know the owner cat. And he reports, Gurgur meow, sir. Four legged, sir. Butter called, sir. Gurgur meow. Gurgur meow, sir. Four legged, sir. Butter called, sir. That is called butler English. So like this, butler English. But here it works. We say I am, you are. What does this am and are mean? Is. Never mind English grammar. Is, she, it is, that it. Is means what? Existence principle. I am means something called I is. You are something called you is. Microphone is. Curtains are means singular is. This isness, wherever that is there, it is the aspect of Brahma Atma. You are listening to me. You are aware of what I am talking. You know what I am talking. You may understand or you may not understand. But you know that you are understood. You know that you don't understand. This knowledge aspect is chitta aspect. You are happy. That happiness is ananda aspect. All these three belong to Brahma. Are you there? Now what is the answer? I am there means what? Isness is there not? Brahma. Do you know you are there? Yes, knowledge aspect. What does it mean? Chit. Do you, anytime are you happy? Swamiji, that is only problem. At least are you happy in sleep? No, you are happy or not?
Yes.
You may not be happy because you don't get sleep. That is, you are happy, is it not? That happiness is what? Atma. Asti, bhati, priya. Easiness, knownness, pleasure, delight, ananda. Atma Brahma. Nama, Rupa, name and form, Jagat. All that Vedanta wants you to dissect now. Big surgery, even cardiovascular surgeon cannot do it. Dissect from Jagat, Nama, Rupa, name and form, and hold on to our Asti, Bhati, Priya, Sat, Chit, Atma. So therefore, it is presented in different ways. Brahma, so that we say, Brahma Tattva Nirdharanatma. To ascertain the principle of Brahma means, to ascertain the principle of I, your nature, the basis of entire Jagat, the very foundation of entire Jagat. I am Arambha. This undertaking, this new valley is being, new section is being started. Why? Yamaraja is not fed up of discipline. He is a teacher. Teacher's main concern is to make the student disturb. If the teacher true to the soul, he will take any pain to make you know the truth. Durvidneyatvat Brahmana. Gaining the knowledge of Brahma is what? Very difficult. Very difficult. Who says this? Not Yamaraja. Ashaka, Shankaracharya. Even Bhagavad Gita Vasha says, why Lord Krishna is repeating, and that also when he is repeating? When Bhagavad Gita starts, at the 0 hour of the battle, time is very important. Even at that time, he has leisure, because Arjuna has to discuss. You know, the question, just because the context has come, nothing to do with India. At the 0 hour of the battle, Krishna gave the Bhagavad Gita teaching to Arjuna. In fact, war was already declared, because Panchis were already broke, means only first arrow is to be shot. The war had begun. The conch is the indication. Both sides at that. I hope you know this episode possibly. See what happened. Both sides blew the equator started by Bhishma. They shot the arrow first. It is as good as shooting the arrow first. And Pandava responded. At that time, Dharma, now the battle started in the horrible condition. Dharmaraja got down from the chariot. He unarmed himself, removed the shoes, and he started proceeding to Kauravas. Bhima, Arjuna are puzzled. What is this? At this dreaded hour he is going there. See, there was a mixed reaction on the Kauravas side. They thought, some thought, he is surrendering. Some said, what a coward. Krishna is there and Arjuna is there, Bhima is there, what is that? They say, Bhima is there, brother, what are you doing at this time, etc. He is lip tied. Krishna signals his people. You also follow the suit. Then they understood something, there must be something. So therefore, they also unarmed, removed the shoes with a folded hand, they followed who? Dharmaraja straight away went to Bhishma Pitama, this Ashtanga Namaskar. He said, grandfather, because of you, we are surviving now. From he rescued them. You are worthy of adoration by keeping in your heart, etc. But you know the circumstances. We have no other option than fight against you. Please give me the permission to fight against you. Is this evening? Bhishma was so happy. My son, had you not sought this, I would have cursed you to defeat. That doesn't mean you go home and fight with the enemy. Give me permission to quarrel with you. Don't say that. So that is it. So you win. Then second question. Grandfather, so long as you are the battlefront, we can't win the battle. Point blank. Please tell us the way to kill you. Straight in. The way to kill you. Bhishma said, that time has not yet come. Punaragamanam kuru. Come again. Not. He went to Dronacharya. Said, we know archery because of we should not fight. He said, don't worry. Wherever there is Dharma, there is Krishna. Wherever there is Krishna, there is victory. Don't worry. So he blessed. Then he went to Kripacharya. Kripacharya. He was the teacher before Dronacharya. Kripacharya, brother-in-law of Dronacharya. Kripacharya's sister, Kripi, is Dronacharya's wife. He said, you are our teacher, guru. Don't worry, but one thing, I am Chiranjeevi. I can't be killed, but you will be there. Then came Mama, Shalya. Shalya. Shalya was actually was a matter of some matter of uncle. He went somewhere. So Shalya was little, he was in soup. He said, beta, ask for anything except fighting on your side. You know what had happened? When this war was declared, Shalya with all his army came to support who? Pandavas. The shrewd Duryodhana encountered him on the way and lavish hospitality he extended. So Shalya was very happy. Said, what do you want? That is exactly what who? That is exactly who Duryodhana wanted. Please fight on our side. He has given the word. So he had to fight on whose side? Kaurava's side. So please don't make me go against the Dharmaraja said, Uncle, I know it. I will never go against the Dharma. I will never ask you to fight on side. But please do me one thing. Because Dharmaraja knew the strategy. Shalya was a master charioteer. Though he was a king, he was a master charioteer. And Dharmaraja knew a time will come, fight will be between Karna and Arjuna. And Arjuna is bound to kill the charioteer of Karna. There is no other charioteer who can match Karna except Shalya. And Duryodhana by his hook or crook will see that Shalya drives his chariot. He said, only do one. If you are asked to drive the chariot of Karna, do his Tejo Bhanga. Tejo Bhanga means dampen his enthusiasm. Curtail his enthusiasm. See, means someone talk in such a way that he gets disheartened. That is exactly Shalya. He said, actually, Sarathi's job is not to talk with the warrior, but he is a king. Karna can't ask him, shut up. he can't ask, shut up. Even. Karna, how many times you fought with Arjuna? Many times. Had you won even a single battle? What match you are to? What match you are to whom? So it means he was discouraging, and that is what happened. Okay, it happened. So he got the blessing of all these elderly people. Return, then you know. Sena yor vayor made sthapaya me katha. Arjuna request, put my chariot in between. I want to personally see who is on the, who are on the Kauravas. And there he got deserted. I'm fighting, killing my own kidnapped king. That is a seed implanted by Jana. Who? Dhritarashtra. See, massive descent. Your own people are there, etc. So at that time, Krishna knew, accept Adhyatma teaching, he is not going to see. The question is, to read Bhagavad Gita, how many hours are required? Minimum 3 hours ago. There is no time to wait for 3 hours. Do you know who Krishna is? Yogeshwara. You know what Krishna did? He changed the time cycle. You didn't? He quickened the time cycle for Kauravas and extended the time cycle for Pandavas and Arjuna. So he took his own time, may not be in the verse is written by Vyasa. He took his own time, but for Kauravas, it appeared just a few seconds out. That is Yogeshwara. That is. So that is Krishna. So that is again. He repeats. You are such a Yogeshwara who has got. Otherwise, Arjuna, there is no time to alter. I will touch you. I will touch you. You will discover the truth. You will utter it. So not that. So that's why. So that means repetition is necessary. Especially some of these professors, etc. They come to Vedanta also, I saw them. And repeating, what is this? He repeating? In spite of repeating the thing. Suppose it's not repeating, what would happen? What would happen? So therefore, so now you should let us see whether this method clicks. And Yamaraja starts from where you know. From your body. You know your body or not? I hope. We start from your body. And you say it and points out. Here is Atma Brahman. So that is Durvidneyatva Brahman.
Puram Ekadasha Dwaram. अजस्यावक्रचेतसः अनुष्ठाय न शोचति विमुक्तश्च विमुच्यते एतद्वै तत्.
Your body means our body. Our body is compared to a city. Now you should be careful here, not present day cities. Greater Bombay Municipal. This is olden day cities like forts. Forts with different gates, then army, gatekeepers, army, ministers, so many materials, etc., etc. Protection also, they want moat, and trench is there, water is there, etc. Easily it cannot be crossed. That. Now this fort is for who? There is a master, owner of the fort is made up of many things. It is an assembly of many things. You have to know this principle. Kaan, made up, assembled from so many parts. We call in Sanskrit Sanghata. Sanghata means an assembly. An assembly of so many things. House, made up of many things. Now tell me, a Sanghata, an assembly is not meant for the assembly, but for the one distinct from them. Car is meant for the owner and not meant for the house. Is meant for the owner of the house and not for the house. Like that, fort is meant for the master of the fort, Swami, king or whatever, not for the. This is the principle to be kept in the mind. Our body is made up of what? So many things. Won't you agree? It is a Sanghata assembly. Means it is meant for the one who is distinct from Sanghata assembly. Will you accept this? That principle is a whom you refer as what? I. But you mistake again. You take the fort as the I. No. The master who is different from the fort is that. This body is meant for whose purpose? That principle is a. So this is the principle based on which our body is analyzed and say, this is an assembly meant for a person different from the Dehadi, Deha, Indriya, Mana, Buddhi, Prana, Sankhata. Ekadashadvaram Puram. This body is like a city, a fort, having 11 gates. Don't get 11. Are there 11 gates in your body? Yes. There are 11 apertures, openings in our body. 7 on the face, 2 eyes, 2 nostrils, 2 ears, 1 nose. How many? 7. Then, navel, 8. Genital and anus, 9 and 10. Brahmarandra. You know, there is something here. Newly born child, you see the head. Love it up. Palpitation goes on. No. Very tender one. Other skull is tight. It's strong. After it gets harder. Yes. You know what it is? It is the last covering or wrapper used by Bhagavan. Just before standing. And before that, he put some grey matter in there. Suppose Bhagavan forgets to put the grey matter, this fellow becomes an idiot. Put the grey matter and then what? He closes and says, but there is one. Have you seen this? Some medicine, bitter, you put in the eyes. Not every time, depending on the type of medicine. You feel bitterness in the throat. Even this Brahmanandra also is connected that way. Oil you put, etc., etc. Anyway, there's a parthena. Puram ekadashadvara. Read. Our body, this anatomical structure, has got 11 opens. Therefore, apply the principle. How many bodies? As far as you are concerned? One. It is made up of, whether you speak of anatomically, flesh, bone, marrow, blood, all the same, or panchakoshas, and all the same. gross body, subtle body, prana, etc. Assembly. You agree? It is meant for one different from who? Different from the body itself. You know, that is Atma, that is Uri. What is nature? Ajasya. Unborn. Your body is born or not? What is not born? Body is born. Body is born. But this principle is aja. Unborn. Body is ja. You know, I don't know. Many decades back, I used to hear on Bombay radio on Ram Navami Day, Ajanma Janma Se Aala. A song. Ajanma Janma Se Aala. Rama is born. Do you know who is he? Ajanma. We have no birth, but has taken a. So it has no. This Chaitanya Tattva I, this pure awareness principle I, has no birth. Ajasya. Avakra Chetasaha. Ajasya means who? Janma Rahitas. Janma Rahitas. Ajasya. That is what? Atmanaha. Atma. This is meant for the Atma, I, free from Janma. Again, Avakra Chetasaha. Chetas is Chaitanya Tattva. Chit Tattva. Pure awareness principle, pure consciousness principle, because of which you are aware of everything, because of which you are able to do many things, because of which you are able to know everything, because of which you know that you don't know this one principle. Avakra. Avakra means avikari, not zigzag. Straight. Kutastha. Avikari. How will you play avikari? For example, sun shines. Sunlight illumines all the world. But does the sunlight take features of the things illumined? Your mind goes on changing. Changing means vikara thoughts. Thoughts take the form of object perceived. But Chaitanya doesn't do that. It simply lives. Means unchanging principle. So that means again, this body is meant for whom he is who? With this body, what all you do? For day to day work. For who? For myself. But we mistake myself as what? Body. Now you have seen, body cannot be. It is meant for the one, me, Chaitanya, who is the master of the body, who is the master of the body, and for whom it is. Now, how to discover? Now tell me, you have what, Atma or not? Even if you say no, the one who says no is Atma. Even if you say yes, you know yes, but you don't know what that is. Then how to know it? Yamaraja is going to explain. You have to do this. You can discover your swarupa, not the mistaken. What is the mistaken I now? Embodiment. This pura. Again, look here. Bhashyakara explains. Puram iva puram. Don't take the Bombay as city. I went to Kathopaji at last. They said there is a city. How many cities are there in the house? Like a city. So that is. A city is meant for the one older city forger, for the Puraswami. Now, what the master of the body, that is me, etc., how to discover its Sarupa step by step is going to produce.
Swasti prajabhya paripalayantam nyayena margena mahi mahisha go brahmanebhya shubhamastu nityam loka samasta sukhino bhavantu kale varshatu parjanyah prithivi sasya sharini desho yam shobharahitah brahmana santu nirbhaya om sarve bhavantu sukhinah sarve santu niramaya sarve bhadrani pashyantu ma kashchit dukha bhag bhave asato ma sadgamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya om purnamada purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vashishyate om shanti 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 hari om shri guru namaha hari om.